Next game we want to discuss, it's New Orleans and New York, the Giants, going head-to-head. The point total is projected at 50. Do you see this as a shootout-type game? We got Drew Brees looking like, you know, Hall of Famer, and Eli is starting to get it together with his offense. So what do you think?
You know, the Giants have been another team that's been playing to the under. They're 8-2 to the under in their last 10 football games. We've seen their offense been anything but explosive. As you mentioned, Eli at least got it going a little bit last week against the Houston Texans. This is an interesting game in which everybody that we speak to likes the New York Giants here. But the Giants have been bad at home. They're not a good home team. They're just not. You know, they've covered three times out of their last nine games at home. They're 3-6 the last nine home games against the spread. Now, I know it's different last year, different coach, et cetera. And, yes, they look good last week. But who's a better football team? The New Orleans Saints? Like, you know, I'll break this down. Do you want Drew Brees, Michael Thomas, and Alvin Kamara? It's like a pickup game here, Maria. You're in a schoolyard here. So you want Drew Brees, Alvin Kamara, Michael Thomas, or you want Saquon Barkley, Odell Beckham, and Eli Manning? If the last one wasn't Eli Manning, I'd be like, ooh, this Odell Barkley train's looking pretty cool.
Yeah, but look, I think they're pretty comparable, but all depends on if that Giants offensive line can protect and can give Eli time like they were able to do last week against a bad team.
The New Orleans Saints, and it's a good point that you raised, the New Orleans Saints have been good. They've been good road favorites as well. They win games on the road. They find ways to get it done. They're 4-1. Their last five times have been favored on the road. I'm not a fan of the hook here at 3.5. And we saw that the Giants played the Jags tough, except Eli just couldn't close the deal. Odell was open a couple of times, but they only lost by 5. They didn't get the 2-point convert. They would have lost by 3. This game just screams 3 points written all over it to me. A lot of people I know a lot of fantasy people are high on Eli this week and stuff. I'm not so sure this game is a track meet, Maria.
Yeah.
My gut instinct tells me the Saints probably win the game by 3, maybe 4 points, but it feels to me like an under this game. I know we don't have it listed as our best bets, but it feels like an under to me. Let's call Saints win 24-21.
All right.
Which is a push in the under.
Yeah, it is. It is. I mean,
you're looking for a track meet.
Well, look, the Saints offense is just so potent. I think they've scored like 35 points. Like
I'll be going to the FanDuel Sportsbook if you want. Give me some money. I'll get it in for you. Maria, watch the over.
Well, you could. Well, that's the thing. I'm afraid my Giants won't be able to keep up, but we could stop at the Meadowlands right on the way to the game.
Remember coming into the year, though.
Yes.
Remember, and even last year, people talked a lot about the New Orleans Saints' improved defense. We haven't really seen much of that so far this year. I think we will this weekend against the Giants. Lower scoring game, in my opinion.
Okay.
Give me the Saints. Probably pushes, though, if you can get the 3. I love it at 3. The 3.5 scares me, but I think it's a lower scoring game. That's it.
That's it. All right. Hey, it's going to be a really fun game regardless.